The next 15 minutes, I will just give you a very quick introduction, a sneak preview of what we're going to release very soon. It's about social and BPM, and it's just in 50 minutes. So you ought to have to be very smart or sharp, or at least remember at least two words. It's about people and process. So basically, the question we asked ourselves, what kind of social tools and techniques can we bring in our platform to make you more effective when working with processes? When I say 10 minutes, it's like a 5-minute introduction and a 10-minute demo. We on stage, we will actually model a process altogether. And when I say we, I learned this morning, I have to specify it. So we is Chris over there from UK. We also includes Matt, who will be there as well, and who will also help me with designing a process. And that's me. We have all seen the impact of social media on our society. We have all seen that the impact has been really phenomenal. If you like it or not, we have seen what happened the last years. We have seen what happened the last weeks or even last months in maybe the Middle East or maybe in London. I don't want to go into a political debate, but at least what we can learn from there is that there are new ways for people to find each other, connect to each other, get the job done, and disappear. Yeah? It's at least a fast way. The question is, how can you make that happen and how can it be beneficial in your business environment? Well, there was an earlier report published by Forrester earlier this year that actually tried to address exactly that question. So the new style of communication, the new way of finding the right people to get the job done together, how would that apply in a social world, in a BPM world? So the Forrester report actually is about bringing the world of social, bring it together with the BPM world to make you as a business professional more effective in your daily work. They actually recognize three different patterns or use case, whatever you would like to call it. The first one is what they say in the report, makes an awful lot of sense to actually start collaborating when you're just about discovering new processes. Yeah? So you need in that phase, you need to do a lot of conversations. And social, to me, is all about managing conversations with people within your organization or maybe people outside your organization. That's the first pattern. Today I will not talk about that because of the we don't have that much time. I will talk about that tomorrow at 2 o'clock. The other one I will talk about today, and that will be the main focus, is what we call shared development. So how easy can we make it for you to model a process together? How easy can we make it for you to maybe design a user interface? Why not just make a design and simply share it with somebody else and ask direct feedback on the UI, not on a separate copy? I'm not sure if you ever had the challenge to write a single document with 3 or 4 colleagues. Well, if you do that the traditional way, it goes like this. You start writing a document. If you're a bit smart, you also give it a version name, so you call it My Report version 0.1. And then you send it out to 4 or 5 colleagues by email. I can assure you, within 5 or 10 minutes, your inbox will explode. You get all kind of nasty questions like, hey, where's the latest version? Oh, Eric, by the way, are my comments already processed? Oh, sorry, I updated the wrong version. Yeah, you know what I mean. Yeah. Just for my curiosity, how many people here are familiar with Google Docs? Can you please raise your hands? Okay, that's very good. We have taken the same metaphor that Google Docs did. So what Google Docs actually did is take a document, bring it, make it available through a browser only, and allow people to directly model at the same document in this case. Yeah? You always have one single point of definition. So the same thing that Google did with documents, we did for any model. If it's a business process, if it's a user interface, organization model, kind of models, user interfaces, MDM, whatever model you like. And we will show you how that works. Last but not least, it's about using social process guidance. So imagine you are part of a business process. You have to make, for example, you have to accept an order. Would it not be great if directly from the process itself you could easily interact with your colleagues, have a conversation with your colleagues, and also manage and capture that conversation as part of the process, so that at any time you have a complete audit trail on what you're doing, who was involved in the decision, and why the decision was taken. Today, I assume you're all doing that offline. So you're on the system, making a phone call, maybe if you're a little bit hip, you You're probably using MSN or Google Talk, but what you're losing is all that communication, all that conversation. How can you bring that all together? We'll talk about that tomorrow as well. Today, again, we believe definitely all these environments are very valid. Today, I will focus on shared development, and then we'll show you in a demo how to do that. If you're familiar with the Cortex product, this is our BPM designer. Probably one of the first things you will notice is that the colors are a bit different. That's what we call whiteboarding. So in the designer, we will enable whiteboarding. That means all the pink stuff up there, that's the stuff I was drawing. But at the same time, you see that Wilfried, who is a colleague of mine, also happens to be online right now, can also be working on the same model at the same time. Yeah? What we're doing actually is a visual merge. So he's drawing, I'm drawing, and we're actually seeing the feedback. He can move shapes, I can move shapes. But finally, we're all working on one single model. Another interesting observation that you can make from here is that it's a browser only. It's good to understand that all we do is just browser only. We don't have any ActiveX, Silverlight plugins or whatever. So this will also work on your Safari on iPad. Yeah? Again, that's also what we'll do in the demo. There will be somebody walking around, I think that will be Matt this time, walking around with an iPad and also be participating in the same model. Yeah? Another interesting observation, like I said before, is we implement it as a generic feature. So this modeling will also work for all the other designers that we have. Again, yes, you will be able to model together with your business users, ask for direct feedback on the model, on user interfaces, decision tables, organization models, case models, business process models, etc. So this is what we'll do. I'm not sure, I asked marketing to make a nice picture out of this, but I'm not sure who is. Who am I? I think I'm the guy on the right, without glasses at least. So I'm working then, starting on a business process. After that, I will actually invite Chris to help me with the model. The two of us will start modeling together, finalize the model. Finally, I will also ask Matt, in this case, to review the model. If we all agree, we will say, okay, this is the model, and we will start executing it. So all from a browser on one single model. So here we go. This is our designer environment. From here, I can just say, start a new business process model. The first thing I will do is just save the model. So I just call it Cordial 8, for example. I'll save it over here and enter in what we call the collaboration mode. So what you see now over here, the color changed actually, and I can just start modeling over here. As soon as I start modeling, I get suggestions. So what could be the possible next step? So in this case, I say, it's about product details. That will be the first step. Of course, I'm getting all kind of suggestions that I'm not using right now. And I can say, okay, there's a decision over there. If it's a huge order, I know what to do. But if it's not, then probably I need some help. So in this case, I will invite, I can simply click on this model. I can invite somebody to actually start working on the same model in three different modes, modify, review, or read. Well, I think that's obvious. In this case, I will say modify, and actually making, in this case, Chris, part of my model. So I will share the model with Chris. At this moment, if you take a look at the right-hand side, he will receive, sorry, that's your left-hand side. On your left-hand side, you will see an email coming in. He can just click on the email, and he just has a link. As soon as he clicks on the link, he will also become part of the same model. You can choose whatever kind of where you look. You can look left or you can look over here because we are in the same model. Yeah. So he will come online in a few seconds from now. And you see also on my side now that Chris is also working online. So I can, for example, set my personal message and say, hey, doing a live demo at Cordial. Yeah, or whatever kind of text. And I can just invite him. Hi, Chris. Please help me with the case of huge orders. And of course, we're capturing all this information, also the unstructured communication, also making that part of the conversation itself. So he can now start working and actually start working on the design. So as soon as he clicks, you see on my screen that there's a flag over there. So that's the area that actually Chris is working on. So while he is working on that part, I can also start working on the other part. So I can say... So I can say, for example, this is about shipping orders. And I can just say, yeah, you see now that we're I can make this change. I'll call it ship order. And I can say, let's complete that activity. And this is about in the case of no. At the meantime, he actually said yes. In the meantime, Chris is now fixing the model to make it good looking again. Yeah. So that's just the early phase. And again, remember, this is just a browser. It will work for all browsers, all modern browsers, Safari, Google Chrome, whatever you like. And it's just a URL. You're only sharing a URL. So it's about the same philosophy again, like Google Docs. All fine. Let's invite somebody else. So in this case, I say, I think we need approval to run it. So in this case, I will invite, and this time it's Matt. It's for review only. And I will invite Matt. So in this time, Matt will come online, also in the model. Matt will be walking around here in the audience. He has an iPad. But on this iPad, he's seeing exactly all the same things all the same time. Yeah. We really have to stretch and see how far this will work, so how far we can do it, but let's see how this works. In the meantime, I'll also show you some of the other features we're doing. At the top, you will see what we call an undo, redo slider. You can just take the slider, move it back and forth, and return the dim image, the diagram, into a specific phase. If I click that, again, it will be consistent. So on both end sides, you will exactly see the same picture. Next to that, what we're doing here is we're capturing the complete history of all the changes. So who has been doing what, why, and when. So if I hover over on the right-hand side in the diagram, you also see what change was made. So if I hover over, we're also highlighting that particular change. And of course, the next step we want to do is also integrate the conversation that we have on the right exactly in the right time here, over here. Yeah? So that you always see in a complete timeline which change was made, by whom, when, and why. At the same time, oh, by the way, Matt is already online. Hi, Matt. Good to see you. Can you please approve the model?
I have the hardest part of this demo. Walk and talk and type.
Okay.
Which is a threat for me.
Yeah.
An opportunity for everybody else. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to change my profile.
Okay. You have a good looking boss? Who's there?
Dark, tall, and handsome.
Yeah, because that's not you. So if you see the image over here, that's the default image we will pop up. But that's certainly not Matt. So in this case, we'll just make a picture of somebody.
Where's the camera, by the way?
One of the good
behind your fingers.
One of the good looking guys. And he will also, from that device, will also participate in this modeling exercise. Yeah, we're still working on some of the final gestures, just to make it completely iPad-proof, but the basic stuff is already working. You see the picture now of Hans from the audience taken right now, and there we go. As a final step, I will actually save the model and start executing it. So to execute it, the only thing I do right now is just drag a user interface on the activity. I'll do this very quick. Don't worry, you don't have to remember that. Just remember two words, people and process. I will start executing it. So to execute it, I have to publish it. I'll get all kind of warnings, which I will safely ignore right now. And I will start running the process. Well, if I run the process over here, it says, OK, it started. I can even say, OK, show me all running processes. And then it says, OK, the process is actually running. It's waiting over there. OK, show me where are you waiting at this moment. It says, OK, I'm running. But by the way, I'm waiting on this particular step because that requires human interaction. So if I go now to my inbox, you will see that there's a task pending for me. I can double-click on the task, and there I will see the UI that we just designed and made actually all together as part of the process. I can say, just tell me that is for customer Eric, it's product number 10, and I need it within 3 days. I can accept the order, complete the task. The task, of course, disappears from my inbox, and you see that the process, if I refresh this, automatically continues in the next step. So what you have seen today is collaborative modeling with three people just sharing a single URL, work together, design together, and run together. That's it.